Iowa has signed Kirk Ferentz to a new deal through 2029. He's making $7 million a year, and almost immediately, once this thing was done, Ferentz decided to basically disband the, what was it called, the Football Diversity Advisory Committee right after they let it be known publicly that they suggested that Ferentz and the AD, Gary Barta, both resign from their jobs because of all the issues that went on like before the COVID pandemic leading up to it, et cetera. They basically...
That's not what happened. You're using the word they incorrectly.
Go ahead.
One person on that committee.
The head of the committee though, right?
Okay, yes. But all the other people that have been involved in the committee have seemingly come out and said, we didn't agree with that. We didn't want that. And they all agreed with disbanding the committee as well. This was not a Kirk Ferentz rule by an iron fist thing.
Okay. All right. So then I read.
Let's be real careful when we're saying that the committee wanted him fired and he disbands the committee. He doesn't have that kind of power or authority. All right.
Right.
One person who happened to be the head of the committee wanted him gone. Okay.
Gotcha.
And everybody else wanted him to stay. And they all agreed outside of him to disband the committee is the way I read the article.
I read two different articles.
I don't read very well. Yeah. So I could have misinterpreted this, but I believe one person wanted to basically take control of the athletic department.
That would make sense. It was a former football player, and I forget his name, but I had read two articles about it over the weekend and was like, man, this seems really fishy. But, you know, Ferentz, obviously, kind of runs the show, right? And will continue to do so. But he had put together this this advisory board to help them get through a rough patch where, you know, he had to fire his longtime strength and conditioning coach over...
Had problems.
Yeah, major problems.
To address these problems. They didn't. What I'm saying does not absolve any of that. They had legitimate issues that needed to get fixed. But I think other people on this committee saw this as a power play and decided, we're not okay with that. We're going to shut this down. We think we have, as a school, addressed many of these things. We're going to continue to address these things, but we don't need this committee to do so, because now this committee has turned into something where it is now just a power struggle, and that's not good for the school. I'm telling you what I think the rest of what I got from what we read, the rest of the people on the committee felt.
I like this different idea here because it's completely different from what I was reading into it initially, right? But obviously you get something like this that becomes political and there's going to be dissenting sides on both sides, right? You get basically this one story of he is a dictator, he runs that whole athletic department, etc. And then you have the other stories that come out that obviously I did not see.
This is a tweet that I saw after all that from Jordan Lomax, who I think was on the committee. Instead of being so quick to write an article, this is him shitting on the people who wrote the first article. Instead of being so quick to write an article, you guys should have reached out to other committee members for their thoughts. This is one-sided article from David Porter's opinion, who's the guy that ran the committee and wanted the one, which I and others disagreed with. David Porter was trying to take control, I think, of the athletic department. And Lomax was one of the people on the committee who said, this is not what happened. This is not at all what is going on. And we're ending this.
Okay. Okay. It makes sense. Yeah, so
that's how I read that.
So now,
I could misinterpret that easily.
No. That makes absolutely perfect sense. Absolutely, because obviously you've got a group of people there that are supposed to have varying opinions, right? You're supposed to all get together and come up with what is best for the school. And I don't know that them firing Ferentz and Gary Barta was going to be best for the school at this point. Let's get back to the contract extension. Through 2029? I mean, what are we talking? And $7 million a year? Like, he was already getting paid.
$7 million doesn't bother me.
Yeah, that's like nothing that crazy. It's a little crazy when you look at it compared to Chip Kelly's, and we'll talk about that in just a second.
But a one-year coach at Michigan State just got more than this.
That's true. That's obviously, like, everybody thinks he had other suitors as well. It's
irrelevant.
It's market, right? It's the market price.
He's making more than this in the same conference, and he's had one successful season.
True. True.
Second-year coach. I shouldn't say one-year coach.
Basically, this is just saying whenever Ferentz decides to hang it up, he's still going to be here. Like, we are not going to force him out, right?
That's right.
So that I do find it interesting that they extended him all the way through, you know, another 7 years. But, man, like, that's a Gus Malzahn deal from a few years ago that we talked about. Oh, my gosh, can you believe they guaranteed this man this much money? And, obviously, there is a buyout here. But, like,
there's a big difference between him and Gus. He's been there for his entire life.
Yeah, like, it's 22, 23 seasons? I mean, it's been
forever. Yeah, like, I mean, forever. Come on. Yeah. This is not Gus Malzahn.
No. But I'm not comparing him to Gus Malzahn. I'm comparing the contracts, right? Because Gus Malzahn's contract that everybody was up in arms about was a fully guaranteed 7-year, $49 million contract, $7 million per year. And everybody thought, what in the world? This is insane.
Oh, that's a new world.
But it's a whole brand new world.
Look at the Big Ten.
Oh, yeah.
Big Ten, you're talking about an 8-year deal and a 10-year deal at Penn State, Michigan State.
Yeah.
All right. This is why Mississippi's going to be real hard to hire top tier coaches, because we still have one of those antiquated laws that says we can only sign a state employee. The maximum contract you can get is 4 years.
Yes. Okay.
Now, the game of college sports has changed when you are starting to give guys that have, you're talking about Penn State that's had two seasons where they've had losing seasons back-to-back that would have gotten people fired at other places. They just gave that guy a 10-year deal, okay? 4 years at Mississippi, ain't going to cut it. Ain't going to cut it. No. These guys are going to get snatched up, and they're going to roll quickly.
Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.